So ngayon po, dadako na po ako kay Apollo Quiboloy. So, Mr. Quiboloy, bibigyan ko po kayo ng pagkakataon na magresponde sa mga akusasyong ito. At marami po sila. Pero unang tanong po, ilan ang miyembro ng KOJC?
Salamat po, Madam Chair, sa pagkakataong ito na makaharap ko ang lahat ng mga nandirito at narinig ko ang kanilang mga testimonya. At magpasimula po tayo kay Ms. Valdehuesa.
Pastor Quiboloy, Mr. Quiboloy, yung Chair, tanong ko muna, ilan ang miyembro ng KOJC?
More or less po, sa tingnan ko po muna ang exact na...
Kahit in estimate po?
More or less po, including mga partners, yung ibig sabihin ng partners, yung hindi pa membro, pero covenant partner na sila, mga more or less 7 million.
So kasama so miyembro plus covenant partners, mga 7 million sa inyong pagkabilang. Okay. Sa mga follow-up question ko po, dun sa mga testimonya na ng mga victim survivors, sinexually abuse nyo ba ang mga babae at mga minor de edad? At wala ginamit pong, nyo ba ang relihiyon para i-sexually abuse
wala
sila?
Wala pong katotohanan yung kanilang mga sinabi. Kung meron po silang mga charges na criminal laban sa akin, malaya po silang mag-file ng kaso at doon ko haharapin at sasagutin sa tamang forum sa korte ng ating lupa tulad ng kinakaharap namin ngayon.
And actually, on that matter and for the record, may at least isa sa victim survivors na dati nang naghain ng kaso sa inyo dun sa Davao, kaya lang dinismiss. Kaya in-appeal nila sa Department of Justice. Yun naman pong mga testimonya ni na Ms. Valdehuesa at ni Yulia. Tinatanggi nyo ba ang mga testimonyang
tinatanggi
iyon?
Tinatanggi ko po. Wala pong mga katotohanan yung kanilang mga sinasabi, kundi sa aking paningin ay kabaligtaran. Ngunit hinahamon ko po silang mag-file ng kaso sapagkat ito'y mga kriminal na mga allegations. At ito ay para maging fair, ay maghain po sila ng mag-file sila ng kaso laban sa akin o kanino mang kanilang gustong mag-file laban sa mga kingdom na leaders or members because we are under the law of the republic. Tulad po kay Masayon, yung kanyang sinabi.
Pastor, i-interrupt ko muna kayo doon dahil tinatanong ko muna yung mga testimonya ni na Ms. Valdehuesa at ni Yulia.
Sorry po.
Pinalimos niyo po ba yung mga bata para i-sustain ang operasyon ng KOJC at para tustusan ang inyong lifestyle?
Wala po kaming mga palisiya na magpalimos ang bata.
Pero walang polisiya man, pinalimos niyo ba sila?
Hindi po. Mm-hmm. Wala pong katotohanan yun.
Okay. Eh yung mga adults po, pinalimos nyo ba sila or pinayagan nyo ba silang maglimos para sa operasyon at lifestyle
ng KOJC?
Hindi po. Wala
pong polisiyang ganun ang kingdom na magpalimos.
Wala mang polisiya pero pinalimos nyo ba sila yung mga adults?
Hindi po. Wala pong katotohanan yun.
Alright. Pinayagan nyo ba yung pang-aabuso at pag-torture sa mga miyembro nyo?
Hindi
halimbawa
po.
Yung parusang dry fast?
Hindi rin po. Polisiya ng kingdom ang batas ng pagparusa ng tao ay ipapasting para mamatay.
Napansin ko po, lagi kayong nagre-refer sa polisiya, pero ang tinatanong ko po ay yung practice. So, pinaaabuso nyo ba, pinatotorture nyo ba yung mga miyembro nyo? Pinapadry fast nyo ba sila?
Sa freedom of religion po natin, meron tayong separation of church and state. At tulad ng sinabi ko, yung fasting ay voluntary kung tatanggapin mo. Hindi po ipinipilit.
Alright. Kayo ba yung nakaisip nung modus na piliting magpakasal yung mga miyembro nyo na hindi naman magkarelasyon para manatili sila sa ibang bansa. Sino pong nakaisip nun, nung modus na yon?
Because this is under the investigation already, I invoke my right to remain silent on this issue.
All right. Quickly lang po kay Ate Gingging, yung dry fast po ba, voluntary ba ito?
No, for sure.
No. All right. Salamat po.
It was an instruction.
Instruction. So, hindi siya voluntaryo, instruction or utos siya. All right. Salamat po. Mr. Kibuloy, boses nyo ba yung nasa audio file kanina, yung binabantaan mo yung si Stephanie o si Pane?
Kailangan po i-authenticate kasi ngayon malakas ang AI.
So pero boses nyo ba yon, yung nagbabanta kay Pane o kay Stephanie?
It appears na parang boses ko, pero
right,
hindi ko po ma-authenticate kasi ngayong panahon na to malakas ang AI.
At kaya, sino po si Stephanie Ibarra? Sino po si Pane?
Isa po sa mga manggagawa.
Manggagawa. Ano po yung relationship o relasyon nyo kay Pane o Stephanie Ibarra?
Isa pong manggagawa.
Isang manggagawa. Pero hindi ba totoo na kinukup nyo siya, kinuha nyo sa inyong pag-aalaga nung siya ay 2 years old pa lamang?
With this issue po kay Pane, I invoke my right din to remain silent.
All right. So, pero sa pagkaalam po namin, inalagaan nyo siya nung bata pa lamang siya. So, parang naging tatay kayo ni Stephanie o Pane Ibarra. Tama po ba?
I invoke my right to remain silent po sa issue na yan.
Okay. Kasi sa audio file naman po, sa kabila nung sa pagkaalam ay kinupkup nyo siya nung 2 years old pa lamang, bata pa lang siya, na parang naging tatay kayo niya. Pero sa audio file, bakit parang asawa? Asawa nyo kung ituring itong si Stephanie o Pane?
I invoke my right to remain silent.
All
on
right.
The issue rin po.
Ngayon po, kinoconfirm nyo po ba na meron kayong isang hukbo o private army sa inyong disposal? At ano po iyang tinatawag na angels of death?
Yan po ay kasinungalingan. Mm-hmm. At kung yan ay akusasyon, inihiling ko ang accuser na mag-file siya ng kaso laban sa akin.
Okay. So, sinasabi nyo kasinungalingan yung isang hukbo na nasa inyong disposal.
Opo.
Pero ano naman po yung angels of death?
Hindi ko po, invento po nila yan eh.
Invento lamang. Ano ang, kanina po kasi sinabi po ni Sir Edward na yung ano ba ito? Yung saan na ba yung notes ko? Teka ha. Okay, Edward. Yung 2nd Metro Davao Signal Battalion may kaugnayan sa Task Force Davao. So, ano ang ugnayan kung mayroon ng Angels of Death dun sa DDS o Duterte Death Squad naman?
Wala po akong personal knowledge niyan, so I invoke my right to remain silent on that issue also.
All right. Tapos pwede niyo bang ibahagi sa amin mula sa perspektiba niyo yung detalye ng law enforcement kung papaano nakuha nila ang kustodiya sa inyo?
Pakiulit po.
Mula sa inyong pananaw at karanasan, paano pong nakustodiya kayo sa kamay ng gobyerno, ng ating law enforcement agencies?
With that issue po, I also invoke my right to remain silent.
All right. Sige. Bago po ako dumako naman kina General Torre, meron po akong IFA flash dito po sa ating monitor. Panoorin natin lahat, pati ninyo, Mr. Kibuloy. Wow. Inaayos lang po yung pag-flash natin dito. Ah, naglalag lamang po, pero andito na sa dito sa gilid. Meron pa lang ako nakikitang ano, pamagat ng event na closing ceremony. Okay. Welcome, closing ceremony. Military orientation training. Baka ito yung binanggit ni Edward kanina na ganitong klaseng training ng mga paaru na nasa 2nd Metro Davao Signal Battalion na may kinalaman sa Task Force Davao, yung paaru sa ilalim ng 11 RCDG or yung 1105th Community Defense Center. Ah, okay. Edward, alam niyo ba ito? Itong closing ceremonies ng military orientation training na to?
Madam Chair, una sa lahat, yung correct ko lang po yung TF Davao, separate po yun, iba yun.
Opo.
Unang training po yun ng batch ng ano worker.
Okay.
But lately, naging ano na, pumasok na sila sa paaro. Yun na yung national. Separate po yung Task Force Davao
okay.
sa paaro. Yung
okay.
paaro nag-start 2015 po,
okay.
Second Signal Battalion.
Okay.
Yan po yung mga lately na yan ng mga batch.
Uh-huh.
Ng mga ano po ng mga training po kasi hindi lang naman sa aming batch 2015 yung may training eh
uh-huh.
But every year nag-help po ng training kung mapapansin niyo po pagkakaalam ko hindi pa Brigadier General po si Buloy nung time na yan nung uh-huh. time namin
uh-huh.
parang bago lang ata yan naging Brigadier General sa ano reserve unit
yes na nakikita natin sa litrato na natakpan lang ng pagbilog sa kanila pero BGen Pastor Apollo C
po,
na I suppose Kiboloy apo pwede nyo bang i-confirm ito Mr. Kiboloy
still on this issue I invoke my right to remain silent din po
okay. So ang kaya ko noted ini-invoke niyo ulit yon ang kaya ko ipinakita sa ating lahat ito dear colleagues ang mahalaga ang military training na ito lumalabas ay para alagaan si Mr. Kiboloy hindi po para sa bayan na ang alam natin sa ating mga armed services yun talaga ang mandato nila so Mr. Kiboloy ginagalang po ng komite namin yung constitutional rights ninyo. Ang mahalaga ay nabigyan kayo ng pagkakataon na magsalita rito. And then ngayon po naman, please of course you will stay on sa hearing para kung may iba pang tanong sa inyo bago tayo matapos, bago tayo mag-adjourn. Ngayon po tungo tayo sa ating law enforcement naman. So kung maaring matanong ko naman muna si General Torre, sir. General, nung nakuha po si Kiboloy, naging usap-usapan po noon kung naaresto ba siya or sumuko ba siya. Pwede nyo bang liwanagan ito para sa amin? Paki-update nga po ang bayan. Once and for all, ano po ba ang nangyari?
At the outset, ma'am, thank you very much for giving us the opportunity to present our side on this August body. This is the second time that we appear in the Senate and in the first time it resulted in our ability to show to the public what is happening during the 16-day operation inside the KOGC compound. And today we do hope to continue with our quest for justice to help the victims look and find and receive the justice that they also deserve. Regarding the arrest of Mr. Kiboloy, in all intents and purposes, in our whole operations, he is arrested because he submitted himself to my representative because he has no other options other than submit himself to the custody of the law. Because whether he like it or not, he has no other options during the time. Because I have 4,500 people around him inside this compound, and 1,200 is concentrated on the two buildings that he has control of. On the part that he is saying that he voluntarily surrendered, it is just on the colloquial and the popular term of this term surrender, because he has no other option. Again, I will stress on that, because all the other units there that provided us with the assistance only provided prisoner transport from the place he is arrested to the place where he is detained. So that's the synopsis of everything that transpired during that day on September 8th, when he took custody of him to make him answerable to the crimes that he is charged of in various courts in the Philippines.
Salamat po, General. And bilang isang sibilyan, isang mambabatas, naiintindihan ko na anuman yung colloquial or popular term na gamitin, ang outcome ay nasa kamay na siya ng ating mga otoridad dahil sa environment na na-create nyo on the ground, no? Kasama itong 4,500 personnel nyo, na yung 1,200 ay dun lamang naka-concentrate sa dalawang building kung saan siya tumagal, no, ng ilang mga araw. Yes, General.
I do believe that the term surrender and arrest is being debated upon. Well, I do believe that he, the camp of Mr. Kibuloy, would like to model the issue on the term the surrender and arrested, because it has great bearing on the criminal case that they are facing, ma'am. So they can use the voluntary surrender term as part of their maybe their defense for and prayer for leniency cite it as a mitigating circumstance. However, it is not the case, and it was never the case in this situation, ma'am.
Well, in any case po, General, tulad ng nagtiwala kami sa PNP na sa tulong ng ibang mga other units na nag-a-assist ay mapapasakamay nyo rin si Mr. Kibuloy, may tiwala rin ang committee ngayon sa Department of Justice na ma-handle alang-alang sa mga victim survivors at alang-alang sa ating bayan yung mga kaso ni Kibuloy. General, ang sabi niyo po ay may mga continuing crimes na nagaganap sa loob ng KOJC compound. At sabi niyo po na may mga iba pang mga biktima na gusto ng PNP pang sagipin. So, pwede po ba kayo mag-elaborate tungkol dito?
As of the moment, ma'am, we are partnering with the Department of Justice in building up other cases to be filed against Apollo Kibuloy and his cohorts, his companions. Last week, we have filed sedition and inciting to sedition charges against them through the Department of Justice and with the assistance of the special prosecutors assigned by the DOJ for this case. And there's still continuing build-up on the possible rescue of other people, because we had experienced the extensive brainwashing. Mr. Kibuloy had a head start of around 30 years against the law enforcement, and we are just scratching the top. And I do believe that as time goes by, as people see the fallacies of his declarations, more people and more victims will be summon the courage to actually seek for the redress that the law is ready to give them.
Maraming salamat para doon, General Torre. Yun din yung wish ng committee ito. At napaka-importante yung sinabi nyo na may build-up pa kayo para sa dagdag na possible rescues. Of course, mga adults din. At lalong-lalo na siguro yung mga bata, tulad nung anak ni Miss Jocelyn, na buti na rescue na rin niya, no? At sa tulong din ng DSWD at saka DepEd. Lastly for now, mula sa akin, General Torre, sabi nyo po, may mga humarang sa inyo sa pag-aresto kay Kibuloy. Ito ba'y, halimbawa, kagaya ng paglalagay ng mga fire truck, iba pang sasakyan para harangin yung highway mismo sa labas ng compound. Ito ba'y mga KOJC members din? O meron ding mga opisyal ng gobyerno? Sa tingin nyo ba ay may involvement pati yung local government sa pagprotekta kay Kibuloy?
Well, on the direct evidence that we have right now, ma'am, we have seen members and non-members alike who had conspired to prevent us from serving the warrant of arrest for Kibuloy, or at the very least make it very, very difficult for us to actually do our job. And it's not for the persistence and faith of my superiors and the people from the government, and also the cooperation and the blood, tears, and sacrifice of my men, we would not have achieved and overcome that the obstacles that they did to prevent us from achieving the mission. We had the experience roadblock after roadblocks, and the pressures, especially considering that the compound is very large and the only coverage that we have there is the SMNI, to which we are actually asking YouTube to take down, considering that it's being used to protect a fugitive not only from the Philippines, but also a fugitive of the laws of the United States. So we're asking YouTube to actually take down the channel of SMNI and also Facebook for them to prevent from using that those social media platforms as leverage for their illegal activities and criminal activities, basically. And at this juncture, ma'am, I would like to thank the Senate for giving us this chance to show our, to tell our story, the side of the story, hoping that this is a hearing in aid of legislation, and I do hope that legislation will really be passed to help us and again give leverage to the law enforcement, because I can really feel that in the 6-10-day operation we have reached the limits of the law, and we have really tested the limits of the law there, and I do believe that we still did everything within the bounds of the law, however difficult it may be. And I do believe that it's time that we also try to adjust the law in the hope that it will be more responsive to the needs of the time, because if we only listen to all those telling us that, especially the lawyers of Apollo Kibuloy, telling us that we are doing things illegally, because for 16 days we stay there without a search warrant, citing that the use of the warrant of arrest as basis of our search and stay there in the compound, which I believe that they are wrong, really gave us this sometimes this sense of doubting ourselves, especially that the propaganda day in and day out is hitting us left and right. And I do think that this opportunity comes, because if we don't adjust and make the law more responsive to the current times, it will create a situation where some people will be definitely beyond the reach of the law, because if we are not that persistent, Mr. Kibuloy will still be out there laughing at us and just telling everything that things that he wants to say, because he will be out, he will be always out of the reach of the law. So thank you very much, ma'am, for giving us this opportunity to be part of the crafting of more responsive legislation, so that we can be better and more effective in our law enforcement and in the assistance and in the implementation of the processes of the laws of the land. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you also, General. And in fact, hindi lang ang Senado, pero iba pang mga institusyon at organisasyon ay nagpahayag ng suporta sa inyong law enforcement operation noong mga linggong iyon. Halimbawa, yung Integrated Bar of the Philippines, Davao. Kahit paglabas ng isang desisyon ng Korte doon din sa Davao, in-affirm ng IBP Davao na valid pa rin yung operation ninyo in order to effectively serve the warrant. And yes, kahit tatlo lang kaming miyembro ng komite o ng Senado ay nakadalo ngayong mabagyong araw, pero lahat po kami, yung chair, si majority leader, si minority leader, ay may nakikita talagang halaga nitong pagdinig natin at yung mga partisipasyon ninyo na mga katrabaho namin sa gobyerno in aid of legislation. At may mga tinutukoy talagang mga lumang batas na baka kailangan amyendahan o mga bagong batas na kailangan nating ipasa. Lastly, General Torre, for now from the chair, ang CIDG po ba tumitingin na rin sa alleged killings na allegedly iniutos ni Kibuloy?
Yes, ma'am. Given the chance, we'll be presenting the results of our initial investigation. For the past 1 month that I'm designated as head of the CIDG, I continued what I started in Region 11. and we are ready to present to this August body and to the public the link analysis and diagram that we had prepared with the accounting of the personalities, including the incidents, including those that were mentioned by the witnesses who spoke before me, ma'am.
I see. General, prepared ba kayo maghain ng ganitong kahit broad strokes kung ano yung pinaka-importanteng mga initial results ng inyong investigasyon nitong nakaraang buwan, pati yung link analysis, or ano ba yung maari nyo nang at pwede nang ibahagi sa komite?
Yes, ma'am. We can show you just one slide, which is collection of, which is basically the simple result of our validation and collation of the information that we have right now, ma'am. It's on the processing, and I will be asking my regional chief of the Regional Field Unit 11 of CADG to show to us the single slide of the link analysis.
Salamat, General. Sir, nakapanumpa naman din kayo kanina, ano po? Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
If you could, sige po. Handa na po yatang
yes, ma'am. While they are preparing that, ma'am, this is still a work in progress, and as time goes by, we do believe that there's even a possibility that the Senate and congressional investigation on the EJK will intersect with each other.
I see.
So
well, that's very important para sa kaalaman ng lahat. Ang investigasyon naman ng Senado sa ilalim ng Blue Ribbon Committee ay magsisimula naman po sa Lunes, 28 nitong buwan, at ang magpapangulo ay si Minority Leader Senator Coco Pimentel.
Yes, ma'am. Well, it's part of his, the link analysis will cover around 30 years. From the start up to the present that we know, based on the declaration of various witnesses. There may be times that things will be for validation. The danger is only libel. Maybe so that's why I ask my personnel to redact the link analysis, remove the names.
Apo.
But rest assured that without the redacted, without the reduction, there will be actual names that will be given in there.
Very well taken, General.
That that will include victims who are already killed, who mm-hmm. had died, and that will include the witnesses that you have just heard today, and mm-hmm. how they are positioned in the network of Mr. Kibuloy.
Wala pong problema sa reduction, General Torre. Isa sa mga best practices din na ginagawa ng aming komite kapag hindi pa pwede o dapat ilabas ang anumang dokumento.
Yes, ma'am. Of course, we also this is a from our standpoint, this is a two-edged sword. Mm-hmm. This will give Mr. Kibuloy the idea on how far we are in the investigation of his organization, but also we are presenting this to the public, hoping that to show the public and the potential, especially the potential victims, the other victims have not yet spoken, have not yet surfaced, to have the courage to believe in us that we are actually in the correct path to the total investigation and comprehensive investigation of the organization of Mr. Kibuloy and his eventual delivery to the Bar of Justice of this land, ma'am.
General, magtitiwala po ang chair sa judgment nyo.
Yes, ma'am.
Kung ano ang tingin nyo dapat at pwede nyo ng isa publiko. Yes, without telegraphing any of your punches sa defense team ni
yes,
Mr. Kibuloy.
Yes, ma'am.
The chair will respect that po. What you want to and can present in public sa hearing na ito, o ano yung gusto nyong isumite na lang muna in writing, or dahil mag-adjourn na tayo, wala nang executive session, but I will trust your judgment po. Ano yung gusto nyong ilabas ngayon in public hearing, ano naman yung gusto nyong isumite na lang in writing, or totally not submit yet habang work in progress yung investigation.
Thank you. I would also would like to acknowledge the immense work of Colonel Hanser Marantan here, the chief of the Davao City Police Office, to my left.
Yes.
They had been working closely with Colonel Jin Likod, my regional chief of the regional Field Unit 11, under the direction of our Chief PNP. Who had given us the instruction to really focus on this operation. Please only flash the Jin. Pakibantayan mo na lang yung link diagram lang.
General, while we're waiting for the finalized, redacted and finalized slide, maybe I can pose some questions kay Colonel Marantan.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, General. Colonel, kaugnay sa isang follow-up question ko kay General kanina, naging usap-usapan din na mayroong mga kailangan pang i-rescue na mga kababaihan at kabataan in particular sa loob ng KOJC. Ano pong actions ang kinuha ng PNP? At may mga rescue attempts ba na ginawa in coordination sa ibang mga government agencies?
Madam Chair, yes. In fact, we have a good accounting with them. I have prepared some slides there for your appreciation. Maybe it's there already on the PowerPoint presentation.
Or baka, Colonel, pwede nating ipakita yung tatlong slides nun, yeah, kasabay or pagkatapos nung iisang slide, yung finalized and redacted na link analysis. So kung pwede, magpatuloy lang muna yung verbal na pagtatanong ng chair sa inyo.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Salamat, Colonel. Marami ding vloggers na nagulat ng... ito na po. O sige, suspend ko muna yung pagtatanong sa inyo, Colonel. Balikan po natin yung slide na pwedeng ipap... kayo rin po, Colonel. Sino pong magpe-present ng slide ni General? Kayong dalawa po. Si General at kayo, sir. At si Colonel Marantan. All right. So the three gentlemen.
Colonel Marantan will do the honors, ma'am.
All right. Colonel Marantan, you have the floor po.
Madam Chair, please allow me to read some lines of this prepared opening statement by the DCPO. So I will cover about four slides there. And i-cover ko yung magbibigay ng statement na may member of the pastoral also. So with that, after nearly a month of daily attempts to arrest Pastor Apollo Kiboloy and his cohorts inside the KOGC compound, which is 30-hectare property in Davao City, on September 8, 2024, he was arrested by the PNP. After various dramas have been witnessed by the public in relation to this arrest, and a number of victims of Kiboloy have slowly surfaced, approached us, and has given significant information about the illegal activities of said personality committed repeatedly over the years. With the painstaking efforts made by the law enforcement agencies, significant revelations were made to our investigators which are relevant to the prosecution of Kiboloy and his illegal activities, particularly in the highly technical scheme qualified trafficking in persons committed by him and his cohorts. These reports were voluntarily offered by the victims to the PNP with high hopes that justice will be served to other victims who were lured by Kiboloy and his victimization. The revelations which likewise appear to be consistent and based on facts led to our investigation on the so-called angels of death, whom Kiboloy exploited to infuse fear among his victims. As we speak, the PNP, with the constant collaboration with different units, are working together to complete the picture of the dynamics of Kiboloy's illegal activities perpetrated over the years. Today, we will also be hearing corroborative statements from one of the victims whose youth have been robbed because of his illegal scheme. With our goal to help this committee identify loopholes and room for improvements for the Republic Act 10364 or the expanded anti-trafficking law and other related laws, it is likewise our end goal to build up airtight cases that could lead to the successful prosecution of cases against him and cohorts. Today, Madam Chair, we are ready to answer questions to help this committee craft legislations as may be necessary. But before that, may I show you some of these slides, whom I know it's pertinent to the topic at bar. Next slide, please. The kingdom of Jesus Christ was founded, yes. I think ito yung tanong kanina na next po, next na. Next slide. Thank you. Kanina, Pastor Kiboloy was asked kung ilan yung members of the KOGC. And probably announced that their members have reached about 8 million followers. However, based on the interviews conducted by us, only about less than 8,000 members are believed to be currently active members of the said religious denominations worldwide. And nakita po ninyo sa screen yung breakdown. And these were all supplied by some of the members akin to the dynamics of KOGC. About 20 countries plus one, the Philippines, about 21 countries ang nailista ho namin dyan. Next slide. Nandyan ho yung mga numero. Next slide. Ito yung simplified projection of the tip scheme of Pastor Kiboloy. First on the recruitment and then the grooming. Doon sa grooming, there will be separation kung sino ang prospect nila na maging subject of the sexual exploitation. Doon naman hindi mag-qualify, doon sa standard, pupunta sa ordinary miracle worker for the forced labor eventually. Next slide. Kanina we were talking about the difference between the lifestyle of the pastoral and members of the simple workers. Next slide.
Please return to one of the
yes, General Torre.
If baka makalimutan na ni Colonel Marantan. This room is the bedroom of Mr. Kiboloy in the Bible school. And there is a bedroom, something like that, looks something like that. With the twin, the lower right corner is the twin tub jacuzzi. Jacuzzi for two persons. Thank you.
And taken from the narrative of the pastorals, this is where the sexual exploitation oftentimes is being perpetrated. Next slide. Yan po yung difference na sinasabi kanina ng mga kasama natin ng mga resource speakers. Next slide. On sexual exploitation perpetrated by Kiboloy after victim is groomed and ready for sexual exploitation. And victimization continued repeatedly through the years and by generation. Through his preaching with the inner pastorals, per narrative of the former pastorals, Kiboloy aimed to acquire 1,000 women and anchored on the biblical story of Solomon, king of Israel, who had 700 wives and 300 concubines. Next slide. Believed to have victimized around 200 women already. Currently, PNP identified 68 female personalities of different ages whom were victimized by Kiboloy's sexual exploitation. Engaged in strict fellowship with the inner pastorals to brainwash them of the purpose of illegal acts. Kiboloy capitalized on the existence of angels of death to sow fear among inner pastorals, doon po pumasok yung matinding compartmentalization na kahit magkakatabi sila, hindi nila alam yung mga nangyari sa kanila. These inner pastorals who subjected themselves on the last rite, which is the performance of sexual activity with the Kiboloy himself. Next slide. Meron ho kaming mga sinundan na mga members of the pastoral. Very fresh pa yung mga experience na they can narrate it. Mamaya ho, maririnig din ninyo yung narrative ni Elias Marie. Next slide. Yung tatlong na-invite natin, invited by the Senate, si Stephanie Ibarra, and three of them, pwedeng i-refer ko lang. Si Olive Campo and Jackie Holtz, Jack Holtz, ay hindi ho nag-respond sa invitation by the Senate. Pinapakita ho namin sa inyo ang due diligence performed by the members of the DCPO. Pero apparently, hindi they did not heed to the invitation of the Senate, especially Stephanie Ibarra. Next slide. Yan po yung mga efforts. Every day, pumupunta yung mga policemen natin doon sa alam ng mga address nila. Next slide. On the way forward, there's an investigation on the land grabbing issues at Barangay Tamayong, on the House of Kibuloy in Garden of Eden, Barangay Tamayong. Next slide. Oftentimes, naipalabas naman ho yung mga photos na ito. Financial investigation on possible money laundering case committed by Kibuloy and KOJC. Investigation on possible tax evasion committed by KOJC and other proprietary businesses owned by KOJC. Investigation on the legality of operations of schools and other business entitled entities owned by KOJC. And the investigation on the involvement of other foundation utilized by KOJC in the operations. Next slide. And with that, Madam Chair, I think the Elias Marie is ready to narrate her ordeal inside the KOJC compound for 10 years.
Maraming salamat, Colonel Marantan. At bago ko tawagin si Elias Marie, well, salamat dun sa presentation nyo rin on ways forward. Ganun ko rin gustong i-adjourn itong hearing mamaya on the ways forward, both dun sa mga investigations and dun sa rehabilitation ng mga victim survivors. One quick follow-up question, Colonel, bago ko i-recognize si Elias Marie. Ano po yung alam ninyo o, ng PNP o natuklasan sa Angels of Death? Na-identify nyo po ba ang mga miyembro ng grupong ito? At saka, meron bang mga government officials o workers na involved sa grupong iyon?
Ikaw sasagot. Ma'am, that will be the contents of our link diagram that will be presented later on.
All right,
and
thank you,
also, ma'am, maybe it's just hindi lang na mention ni Colonel Marantan. The investigation has already extended up to out of the country. Colonel Marantan has just arrived from Europe, from Austria in particular, interviewing the pastorals that are already based there. So the investigation is not only limited in the Philippines now. We had already sent agents, and we thank the PNP, our Chief PNP, General Marbil, for supporting us and to go sending officers, actually, as far as Austria to conduct the investigation. Thank you.
Salamat din, General Torre. Mukhang na-upload na yung slide ng link analysis. Gusto nyo bang ipresenta yung pinaka-importanting aspects nito bago ko i-recognize si Elias Marie?
I'll give you the opportunity, ma'am, to Colonel Jean Licod, the Regional Field Unit Chief of CIDG Region 11 based in Davao City.
Right. Salamat, General. Colonel Licod, you have the floor po to present the highlights nitong slide.
To the Chairman, Madam Risa Ontiveros, ma'am, good afternoon. The other members of the Senate and, of course, the distinguished visitors, good afternoon to everybody. The presentation that I will be making this afternoon is just to support whether or not there is an existence of angels of death. So if you don't mind, if we could just go back just a little bit to the background, ma'am, so that I can read.
Please proceed, Colonel.
Just to read a little bit with the background of the so-called angels of death. Pastor Apollo Cubiloy, the self-proclaimed appointed son of God, has used the term angels of death to threaten the members who violate the doctrine, teachings, and code of secrecy of KOGC. Thus, the angels of death was established in 1990. Apollo Cubiloy handpicked trusted members with background in military and security training to compose the Angels of Death, which later on utilized as liquidation team to various KOGC locations nationwide. Members reportedly possess firearms and are supervised by Crescente Chavez Canada, or also known as Enteng, and Ingrid Canada. So you might be smiling right now, but later I will prove it to you in the succeeding slides. These angels of death reportedly operate as a secretive, loyal group within the KOGC ministry, capable of imposing both physical and psychological harm on those who do not comply with Cubiloy's wishes. The very name, angels of death, suggests a level of intimidation and power that goes beyond mere spiritual guidance. The allegations paint a picture of an organization that functions as a private army, a weaponized wing of Cubiloy's church used to coerce and control members, particularly vulnerable young women whom Cubiloy has allegedly abused. On the part of the investigation, as the primary investigation office of Philippine National Police, and in behalf of my director of the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, we have set some objectives pertaining to the very existence, whether or not the Angels of Death does exist or not. So we established some objectives to prove whether or not Angels of Death exist. Second, reinvestigate dismissed cases involving deaths by members of Angels of Death. Third, identify the crimes perpetrated by the alleged Angels of Death and its surrounding circumstances. Fourth, identify the degree of participation of members and provide evidence for filing of appropriate charges in court. Definitely, we have to find evidence so that we can file a complaint before the court. As to the efforts that is being undertaken by the CIDG in particular and the PNP in general, we are continuously identifying the alleged members of Angels of Death, profiling of the alleged members, interview of victims' family, relatives, and witnesses relative to the crimes perpetrated by the alleged Angels of Death, thorough and discreet validation on the involvement of the alleged Angels of Death relative to the death of former KOGC members, coordination with other intelligence units, the local police, the AFP, counterparts, and other agencies for case build-up and possible operations if evidence warrants. And next is continuous monitoring and gathering of information and submission of development report as obtained. Now, ma'am, I would like to bring your attention to the diagram being shown in this slide. We would like to show you how is the flow of instruction being undertaken. Of course, as we all know, that the KOGC is a structured organization, but this one, it is not an structured organization. Kaya yung Angels of Death, ma'am, is the term that is being used. But it is not an organization. It is how, in this diagram, how the instruction is being relayed or being followed by the members. Well, of course, on the right corner, as you can see, is Pastor Apollo Cubiloy. Based on that diagram, Madam Chairman, there are four. na kanyang pinagkakatiwalaan ng kanyang mga instruction. Si Mr. B, of course, Mr. Crescente Canada, si Ingrid Canada, at saka si Pastor Acobo, based on the diagram. Yan, ma'am, yung apat na mga pinagkakatiwalaan niya. As of now, base doon sa mga nakukuha nating mga interviews and affidavits na nakuha natin. So, yan ang lumalabas sa ating structure.